Hello everyone, I'm Bruffy1322. So in yesterday's top speed testing video, I talked about how stancing these tuner cars and putting low grip tires on will result in significantly higher top speeds, but completely ruin the handling so they're not useful in races. If you want to see what top speeds they achieve and more explanation in general, check out the top speed testing video, which I'll leave a link to in the description and pinned comment. And if you did see that video, but you didn't see me talk about it, watch it all the way through instead of leaving as soon as the number one car is shown on the countdown. Now, in general, it is the case that stancing the car via the interaction menu gives a small boost to top speed, putting low grip tires on at the LS car meet gives a bigger boost, and doing both together gives the biggest boost. However, in that setup, it becomes unusable for any race that even has a single corner. And even though I did say in that video not to go into a race with any of these setups, there were still more than a few questions about whether stancing the car alone would be worth doing for races, since most of the handling problems come from the low grip tires, and perhaps it's worth it for a slight top speed boost. Well, it isn't. And that's why I said to not use anything but the default stance height and regular tires if you're using any of these cars in races. Granted, stancing the car isn't as bad for cornering ability as low grip tyres, but it's still much worse than normal, with chronic understeer meaning you have to slow down much more to make each corner, and the slight top speed increase you get isn't worth it across a lap. Not to mention the stance cars become awful over bumps and curbs, so you'll have that to deal with. And in the end, a stance Calico is about 3 seconds per lap slower around the track despite its slightly higher top speed. I imagine there will be a few outlier tracks where stancing will be quicker, but there'll be very few and far between, and certainly none of the tuner street racers will be better with a stanced car. Oh, and also keep in mind that respawning in a race reverts the stance height back to normal too. Since there were so many people who asked about it in yesterday's video, I figured it was worth making a quick clarification here. I hope that makes everything a bit more clear. And like I said, if you haven't seen either the lap time or top speed testing videos which cover the performance of all the new tuners DLC cars, I'll link them both down below in the description and pinned comment. Thank you guys so much for watching, I hope this has all been helpful, and I'll see you next time.